discuss about substitution method which is given in 3.3 in the starting of exercise. You will see this name. So what is substitution method? Try to understand. So in exercise we are having, okay, this name. This name is having a meaning. Meaning means, what is meaning of substitute? Means replacement. So we have to replace. But what we have to replace? Try to understand. In every question you will get pair of linear equations in two variables. So I mark here one method to remember it. I will give details. Then we will follow all these in calculations. Equations. Usually they give two equations because this chapter is based on pair of linear equations in two variables. So we have two equations. A1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0. And a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0. Give them names. Suppose they are 1 and 2. Now, when you start your work, very first thing, try to remember in graphical work. What you did there? You were writing every equation as y equal to. But it is not compulsory always to write y equal to some value. You can convert equation into x equal to some value. Means we can say, no need. You can find y in terms of x or x in terms of y. But I will follow the same because you did in graphical work in the same way that you were writing y equal to some value. So we will write the same in this case. So from any one out of these two, sorry, I marked one here, it is two. In any one out of these two, okay, just find y's value in terms of x. So from any one equation, find y in terms of x. So we will find y in terms of x from any one equation, and you have to keep in mind which equation you used. And when you write y in terms of x from one equation out of these two, then other will left. So we will put this value of y into other equation. Put this value of y into other equation. When you see y in the other equation, for example, if I have y's value from first, it will be in terms of x. Means you will see full expression of the right side in terms of x. And when I replace y here in this, then it will eliminate y and your whole expression will come in x. So I am writing here now, put value of y into other equation and solve. When you solve, get value of x. It will give you value of x. Now you need answer of y also. From where y will come? When you mark there from any one equation, find y in terms of x, you can mark here, give it number 3. This will be your third equation when you write y equal to some value. So we will put this value of x in that third equation and solve for y. So after putting this x from third, you will get answer of this y. Okay, when you put x in third, you will get answer of y. So you have two answers, and when you get two answers, don't forget to declare answer. Then declare answer, and answer I will tell you how to declare in the end. So this is substitution method, very easy, little bit related to graphical work in this calculation of y. Then directly you will get answer, and step by step we are moving towards easy work. Graphical work was very lengthy. This method make your work more easier, and easily you will get answers without drawing any graph. So we will start 3.3 now after this. See what is given there. In first question of this 3.3, you have solve the following pairs of linear equations by substitution method. So we have to solve these equations by substitution methods. I am going to start from part number 1. See part number 1, x plus y equal to 14 and x minus y equal to 4. Two equations are given. So let us start it. Give them numbers. Equations are, we can mark here, equations are, what are the equations? These two, x plus y equal to 14 and x minus y equal to 4. So I am going to explain again all these steps which we did. So we have equations. What we have to do first? We will find y. Find y from any one equation. This you marked in the plan. In the details we can say. So we have to find y from any one. Let me give numbers. Suppose they are 1 and 2. From any one you can find y. So I am going to start from equation number 1. But you are free to solve second also. You can do anything. So I am just right here. I am going to start from 1. 1 is x plus y equal to 14. Just solve it for y. Shift x there. It will be 14 minus x. And name it as, name it as third equation. I marked in these details given for this method. So give it number 3. Then after this, what you need? You have to put in other equation. So what is other equation? You used it earlier, already here. So 1 left, equation number 2 left. So we will put in equation number 2. Put in 2, see where you have y at this place. So we will replace y by its answer, that is 14 minus x. And students, take care of this negative sign, because this negative sign you have to write properly. Otherwise, if you forget to change sign of this minus x, then you will not get proper answer. So I am writing this 14 minus x in a bracket because it's minus sign. Then you have equal to 4. Solve it for, see, your whole equation is in x. So what will come? You will get answer of x here. So we will get answer of x. X minus 14 minus minus plus. And you will get x here equal to 4. Then shift 14 there. 2x equal to 4 plus 14. Or x equal to 18 over 2. It will give 9. So we have x equal to 9. And if you have an answer of x, still you need one thing. Find x and put where it, you have to put this, put in third, because in third you have direct answer of y with the help of formula. Otherwise you can put in 1 or 2 also if you want. So we will solve now from equation number 3. So we will put in third equation. When you put in third, you will get answer of y. Y equal to 14 minus x. What is x? X is 9. This will give us 5. Or y, in that you have 5. And in that explanation I told you, declare answer. See how we declare answer. Therefore, x equal to 9, y equal to 5 is the required solution. Write in this way in the end. Don't leave question here only after writing x, y. You have to write answer in the proper way. X equal to 9. Y equal to 5 is a required solution. If you want, you can verify it also in examination that whether your work is correct or incorrect. For that, you can put x and y, these two values, in the left side of that equation. Any one equation you can use. And similarly, if there is any variable in the right side, you can put in the right side also. You have to see both the sides are coming equal or not by putting these values of x and y. For example, here, x 9, y 5. 9 plus 5, 14. And you have right side also 14, it means it is correct. So before leaving this question in examination, when you solve it, once check your answer is correct or not by this method. Put in any one equation and check both the sides are equal or not. Now we will start part number 2. See what is given in part number 2 of this. And we will go for calculations in there. That part number 2. In part number 2, we have first equation s minus t equal to 3 and other is s over 3 plus t over 2 equal to 6. Now we have new variables s and t. So let us start this part number 2 by using these. Still I marked okay here. We have this same to use all the steps I marked along with the solution. If you have any just okay difficulty, you can write in the comment box also if you feel any difficulty of any type. So we have first equation. We can mark equations are. What are the equations? s minus t equal to 3. So this will be our first equation. Second is s over 3 plus t over 2 equal to 6. But here you have denominators. First of all, leave these denominators, and how will you remove these denominators? Denominators we can remove by finding LCM. So we have to take LCM of this 3 and 2, their LCM is 6. So 3 into 2, 6, 2 into s, 2s in the numerator. And 2 into 3, 6, 3 into t, 3t. This is an easy work for you because I think you are doing from many years before this 10th class. So we have this. Now cross multiply 6 into 6, 36. So you have 2s plus 3t equal to 36. Mark it as second equation. Now this step is over. We have our equations. Secondly, find y from any one equation and name it as 3. But we don't have y, we have s and t. So you can find any one s or t in terms of the other. Here from first, it looks more easy. So we will start from 1. From 1, we have s minus t equal to 3. I will shift t to the right side and get answer of s. So I have s equal to 3 plus t. Give it number 3. Then here you mark, put in other equation. So now we have equation number 2 left. We will put answer of s in terms of t into second. So we will write, put in equation number 2. Solve equation number 2 by using it. See, here I have 2s. What is s? 3 plus t. Write in the proper way. Plus 3t equal to 36. Then solve it. 6 plus 2 times t plus 3 times t, 36. 3t plus 2t, 5t. And 6 when go there, it will give you 30. And t equal to 30 over 5 or 6. So you have t equal to 6. We have answer of t. Now we will go for calculation of the other variable. See, mark. When you put in other equation, you have answer of x here. I mark because it is for xy. Now you have answer of t. And after getting this, where we have to put? Put in third. Now we will put in equation number 3. So we will write here, put in third. And third will give you answer of s. S equal to 3 plus t. What is t? T is 6. So you have answer of s equal to 9. And last you have to declare the answer. Answer means, therefore, we can say s 9 and t 6 is the required solution. So they are very easy, they are not difficult. If you follow all these steps, there will not be any difficulty. Let us see what is given in third part of this. The third part of this question number 1, 3x minus y equal to 3, and other is 9x minus 3y equal to 9. So I am going to start solution of this. First of all, we have to give number. So I am going to write directly here, okay, equations are 3x minus y equal to 3, 9x minus 3y equal to 9. Give it number 1, but before giving any number to equation number 2, this is equation number 2 here. So we usually write 2 for this. Before giving number, see what is common in both the sides. Here you have left side with 2 values, so take 3 out from these. It will give 3x minus y equal to 9. Shift 3 there, and when you shift 3 to the right side, it will give 9 over 3 or 3. So we have our equation number 2, to which we give number 2, okay, we can say this one. And little bit observation required here. See, our first equation is this one. Second also here, we have, they both are exactly the same. 3x minus y equal to 3, 3x minus y equal to 3. They are exactly same. And if they are exactly same, then there will be a difficulty to solve in that way. Remember it. Why? Just see. Okay, reason I will tell you now. You have to mention here, because equations 1 and 2 are exactly the same. If they are exactly same, then from 1, this one, 3x minus y equal to 3, interchange these. 3x minus 3 equal to y, or I am able to say it is 3x minus 3, y equal to 3x minus 3 or y equal to 3 outside x minus 1. So this is like a formula. Whether you solve one equation number or equation number 2, there will be a formula type value in which, try to remember graphical work, in graphs you were writing only two values and getting two answers for y when you were putting values of x. But there was no restriction to use two values. That was our convenience only, we used two values, but you can use infinitely many values there. Same here. If I put any value of x, then there will be corresponding answer of y. And how many values we can put in place of x? I'm able to use 1, 0, 10, 15, 100, 1000, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, any value I can use here. And accordingly, when I use some value of x here, there will be answer of y. So here we can use infinitely many values of x, and there will be infinitely many values of y. So we can write here we can put infinitely many values of x, then there will be infinitely many answers of y. And if there are infinitely many values of x possible, infinitely many values of y possible, so there will be infinitely many solutions for this sphere. So therefore there are infinitely many solutions for given pair of equations. So there will be infinitely many solutions for this given pair. You can solve it with the help of conditions also. You can find a1, b1, c1 and a2, b2, c2 by writing them in standard form. Then show their ratios are also equal. If they all gave the same answer, in that condition we say there is a pair of coincident lines, or we can say there are infinitely many solutions. So you can use this method also, or write in simple way in this form, because for this we can use infinitely many values of x, then corresponding infinitely many answers of y will come. So this pair will have infinitely many solutions. So follow this method, students. A different part given along with the calculation work, so remember it, it may come in examination also. So very important. Fourth part is little bit different here. We have decimals. It is to 0.2x plus 0.3y plus equal to 1.3. Fourth part is little bit different. In fourth part you have 0.2x plus 0.3y equal to 1.3 and 0.4x plus 0.5y equal to 2.3. So we will start now this fourth part. Given equations are, or you can say equations are 0.2x plus 0.3y equal to 1.3. Very first thing, try to leave decimal, because decimal may create problems in calculation for you people. Since they all are having one decimal place, so let us remove decimal. For one decimal place, we write 10 in the denominator. And one more thing, don't cancel in this way. First of all, find LCM of the left side, then only cancel. So you have LCM 10. This will give only sum of 2x and 3y, and 13 over 10 is there. You can cancel 10 with 10, or you can cross multiply and cancel. That is your convenience. So we have 2x plus 3y equal to 13. This is our first equation. Now the same work we will repeat for equation number 2, which is, okay, this 0.4x plus 0.5y equal to 2.3. I am not giving directly number 1, 2 to them. After solving, I mark 1 here. Similarly to this equation 2, when you solve, give number then.
So this is in the same way 4 over 10 x plus 5 over 10 y 2 3 over 10 also. Take LCM of this. LCM is 10. 4x plus 5y 23 over 10 cancel. So you have 4x plus 5y equal to 23. Now give it number 2. Now we will follow these same steps. I mark where you can see these also. From 1, 2x plus 3y equal to 13. You can find this 3y equal to 13 minus 2x, and in the end y equal to 13 minus 2x over 3. Give it number 3. This is third equation. When you got here, okay, when you have answer of y, you are now able to put this value of y into the other equation. So I am going to use this y's value in equation number 2. So I will write here put in 2. It is 4x plus 5y. Y is with you. 13 minus 2x over 3 equal to 23. So we have this equation now. It is in x. We will solve it for x now. See, 4x. Students, here there will be some difficulty if there is any negative sign, but you don't have any negative sign. Before solving or before finding LCM, remember one step. Separate this 5. This 5 we have to multiply with the numerator. So write it along with the numerator, not multiply once. Simply write along with the numerator. I am not doing any calculation, I am just writing this 5 along with the numerator. I am separating denominator, and it is equal to 23. Now find LCM. Don't shift 3 there, because here you have 4x also. So we will find LCM of these. LCM of left side is 3. So 3 into 4, 12 along with x, then plus sign, 5 into this same will left, because you have already denominator 3. We have this equal to, sorry, I marked here 12, it is 2. So here you have 2. Now you have to solve numerator, and we will shift 3 there. Cross multiplication will be there. So 12x plus 13 into 5, 65 minus 10x, and I am shifting 3 there. It will give 23 into 3. 69. We have to continue our calculation work. We will solve it further for answer of x in this case. So let me write for you. We have here, this is 12x minus 10x. It will give us, what will come here? 2x. And when 65 go there, it will give us 69 minus 65. It will give 4, or x equal to 4 over 2. Lastly, you can mark here answer of x 2. We have answer of x. Now we will go for answer of y, and from here you will get answer of y directly from third. So put in 3. Third is here y equal to 13 minus 2x. X means 2. Over 3, 13 minus 4 over 3, or 9 over 3. Lastly, it will give us answer of y. Y equal to 3. So you have to getting answer of y. Declare answer. See, therefore x 2, y 3 is the required solution. This is our answer. Fifth part is very important part for examination. Here you have under root 2x plus under root 3y equal to 0. Then second has under root 3x minus under root 8y equal to 0. So we are going to start solution now. Given equations are, what are the equations? Square root of 2x into 3y equal to 0. Give it number 1. And second is square root of 3x minus square root of 8y equal to 0, equation number 2. So I will follow the same. I am not giving details now. I will write answers by giving few details. From 1, square root 2x plus square root 3y equal to 0. So I know I have to keep y in left side, so I will write under root 3y equal to shift this square root 2x, it will be negative square root 2 then x. Then y equal to give it number 3. After getting third equation, what we do always? Put in equation number 2 because we used 1. From 1 we got this answer. So we are going to put into second equation is here, square root 3x minus square root 8 and y. Y is this value. This is y equal to 0. Now open this square root 3x minus minus plus square root 2 into square root 8, square root 16 over square root 3x equal to 0. And it will give us, further I will solve here along with it, square root 3x as it is. Here you have square root 16, we can mark it as square root 4, square root 16, and under root 3 in the denominator, x equal to 0. See, this whole left side is having x common, so we will take x out, and what is left inside is square root 3, 4 over square root 3 equal to 0. What is your requirement actually? You need answer of x. So we can easily find x in this case. Don't waste time in solving this, because ultimately when you solve it, there will be some number and that will have product with this x, and when you shift that number to the right side, that will go in the denominator. So same we are going to do here. We will mark x equal to 0 over this whole value, shift to the right side, and 0 over any number gives 0. We have answer of x. X is 0. Then after getting this x, put in where? In third equation. It will give answer directly for y. So y equal to square root 2 with minus sign over square root 3 into x, which is 0. And 0 will give answer 0 when you multiply with any number. So you have y 0. And we will declare our answer. Therefore x equal to 0, y equal to 0 is the required solution. So this is our required solution of part number 5. Very important part, remember for examination, and little bit different in calculation work also we have. Okay. So next is our part number 6 of question number 1, in which you have first equation 3x upon 2 minus 5 upon 3y equal to minus 2. So let us start with it first. See, there are denominators of the left side. We have to remove them. So first of all, we will find the LCM. LCM of 3 and 2, 6. So 2 into 3, 6. So 3 into 3, 9x in the numerator. Here, 3. 3 into 2, 6. 2 into 5, 10. 10y equal to minus 2. Then cross multiply and see what answer will come here. 9x minus 10y. 6 into 2, 12 with minus sign. Mark it as first equation. This is our first equation in this case. Now we will go for equation number 2. This one we have, I am writing, and this is second one, this is 13 over 6. Again find LCM of left side. LCM is 6, it will give 2x plus 3y equal to 13 over 6. You can cancel this same value and you will have answer of this left side, which is 2x plus 3y equal to 13. Give it number, equation number 2. Now we will start calculation work from, we can say 1. You have 1, 9x minus 10y equal to minus 12. Because this term is negative, I will shift this to the right side and this 12 to the left side. It will give 9x plus 12 equal to 10y, or 10 when you shift in the left side, it will give 9x plus 12 over 10 equal to y, and in the end you can say y is equal to 9x plus 12 over 10. And to this equation we always give number 3. So this is third equation. From this 3 we will put value of y into this equation left, which is equation number 2. We will mark here put in 3. So when you put in 3, see equation 3 is put in 2. Equation 2 is 2 into x plus 3 into y. What is y? Y is here. This is 9x plus 12 over 10. And is equal to what? It is equal to 13.
Now solve it as we did earlier. First of all, I will separate numerator and denominator. So it is 3 into numerator over 10 equal to 13. Then go for LCM of this. What is LCM of this? 10. So 10 into 2, 20x plus 3 into this whole numerator will left because it already have 10 as denominator. So 10 into 1, 10. So 1 into numerator will give the same value. So it will give 20x plus 9 into 3, 27x, 12 into 3, 36, and 10 into 13, when you cross multiply there, it will give 130. Then 20x plus 27x, it will give 47x, and it is 130 minus 36, and it will give 94, and x will be 94 over 47, which is cancelable on 2, so we can say x is equal to 2. You have answer of x, and after getting this answer, from where you will get answer of y? From third equation. So we will write here, put in 3. And when you put in third equation, solve third by putting x, y equal to 9 into x, which is 2 plus 12 over 10, 18 plus 12 over 10, or 30 over 10, and you will have answer 3. So our y equal to 3. We have answer of y. So you have both answers. In the end, declare answer. Therefore, x equal to 2 and y equal to 3 is our required solution. So I am going to write here in this side. Therefore, x equal to 2 and y equal to 3 is the required solution. So this is our required solution of given pair. I hope you understood this part. They all are important parts for examination point of view. So don't leave these.